Hello everyone. In today's episode, I will be talking about magical Kapp-Raker constant and beyond. Before I talk about Kapp-Raker constant, let me talk about not so famous Indian mathematician D.R. Kapp-Raker, who was born in the year 1905 in Maharashtra, India. He was a self-taught Indian mathematician who loved the numbers and their properties. He attended secondary school in Thane near Mumbai. He won the Wrangler R.P. Paranjpe Mathematical Prize in 1927 and he was graduated with a B.Sc. in 1929. He was appointed as a school teacher of mathematics in Devlali, a town very close to Nasik. He spent his whole career teaching in Devlali until he retired at the age of 58 in 1962. He discovered the Kapp-Raker constant in 1949. Many Indian mathematicians laughed at Kapp-Raker's number theoretic ideas, thinking them to be trivial and unimportant. But the international fame only came in 1975 when Martin Gardner, an American mathematician, wrote about Kapp-Raker and his numbers. So here I begin with what we mean by a Kapp-Raker constant. Step 1, take a 4-digit number with different digits, which means you cannot use 1111, 2222, 3333 and so on. Form the largest and the smallest number from these 4 digits. Step 3, find the difference of these numbers. Step 4, repeat this procedure, that is the step 2. The iterative process always converges to Kapp-Raker's constant 6174 in at most 7 steps. Let me consider one example. Let's choose the number 3524. It has 4 digits 3, 5, 2 and 4. Form the largest and the smallest number. One can easily observe that 5432 is the largest number which can be formed and 2345 is the smallest number which can be formed. Subtract them. We have 3087. Repeat this procedure now with a newly formed number 3087. Remember to use this number 0 at the left hand side of this smallest 4 digit number so formed. Repeat the same procedure with the newly number formed, which is 8352, and we observe that we arrive at the number 6174 as desired in 3 steps only. In fact, you will find if you now consider the largest and the smallest number from 6174, it will again give us 6174 only. 6174 here is referred as the kernel for 4 digit numbers. Let me choose another example. Say the chosen number is 5644. So 2 digits are repeated here. Form the largest and the smallest number. Get their difference. With a newly number formed, repeat the same procedure. Again with the newly number formed, repeat the same procedure. And we again, just in 3 steps, get the number 6174. Let's consider one another example. Choose the number 3165. Repeat the same procedure. Please make note of these steps. Now, after at the most 7 iterations, you will get the number 6174. What about the 2-digit numbers? What about 3-digit numbers? What about 5-digit numbers? Or what about 6-digit, 7-digit, 8-digit numbers and so on? Here the number of digits and the corresponding kernel is given by the following table. If the number of digits in a number is 2, there is no fixed kernel value. In fact, there is some looping which I will be talking very soon. Similarly, for a 5-digit number, there is no kernel value, and for the 7-digit number, there is again no fixed kernel value, and there are the loops which will be formed. For a 3-digit number, the kernel number is 495. But when we talk about, say, a 6-digit number, there are two possibilities. Either the difference will end up with 549945, or it may end up with 631764. Same with the number 8, two different possibilities. With number 9, two different possibilities, and with 10-digit number, there are three possibilities. This is a very important property. You must have observed that all the kernel values, they are a multiple of 9. And as in the case of number having 2 digits, 5 digits and 7 digits, there will be the loops which will be formed, and the loop numbers are again the multiple of 9. For a 3-digit number, the kernel value is 495. Let me explain this by using one example. Let the number chosen be 912. Check out the same method. Largest minus smallest number. With a newly number formed, repeat the same procedure. And you have 495. Let me choose another example. The number is, say, 100. Check out the method. So, after 6 iterations, you have the number 495. So, you may try out this with any 3-digit number. You will always end up with 495. As mentioned that there is no kernel value for the 2-digit numbers, all 2-digit numbers enter in the following loop. Given by 9, then 81, then 63, then 27, then 45, and this loop will repeat itself. For example, let's consider a 2-digit number 28. Check out the method here. Largest number formed is 82, smallest possibility is 28, subtract them and repeat this procedure. So, you will observe that 8th step, and this matches with the 3rd step 9. So, after 9, you will now find that again 81 will come, then 63, then 27, then 45, then 9, and so on. So there will be a simple looping. Again, for a 5 digit numbers, there is no kernel value and they enter any one of the following loop. So there are 3 different possibilities in case of a 5 digit number. Consider the first possibility. I have chosen the number as 35768. I have done this for to save the time. Observe that after 9 steps, it matches with the fifth step number 74943. So the looping will be formed here, which matches with our case A. Similarly, let's take up the number 21549, and here you will find that it matches with case B, and let me take case C. The number chosen is say 9553. Just after 2 steps, we have the looping of case C as mentioned. As mentioned, there is no kernel value for the 7 digit numbers and they always end up with entering in the following loop. For example, let's choose the number 2346721. You can check out the iterative process over here, and as mentioned, after 15th step, it matches with the 7th step 8429652. So it will enter the loop here, which matches with the given series. There is an online calculator available. You may use this to verify all the results. And in fact, the students who are in grade 11th or 12th and having the computer science, they may like to make the program using say the Java or C++ or Python language. There is a lot of confusion about the Karpuraker constant and Karpuraker number. So I will quickly talk about what exactly is a Karpuraker number. It is different from so-called Karpuraker constant. A Karpuraker number n is such that n square can be split into 2 so that the 2 parts sum to n. For example, 45 is actually a Karpuraker number because 45 square is 2025. And when we split it into 2 parts, 20 and 25, and add them, it is the original number 45. Few more examples of Karpuraker number are as shown. We already have seen for the number 45. Let's check out for the number 297. Consider square of this number and divide it into 2 parts. Observe that their sum is the number itself. So 297 is the example of Karpuraker number. 9, 99, 999, and so on. They all are Karpuraker numbers. The first few Karpuraker numbers are listed here for your reference. There are infinitely many Karpuraker numbers. Now, finally, the task for you. In how many iterations in the number 7294 you arrive at Carpacker constant 6174? Second question, for a 3-digit number 378, in how many iterations you arrive at its kernel value 495? Third question, find the kernel value for 6-digit number 291754. Fourth question, show that 2728 is a Carpacker number. And fifth question, show that 999 is a Carpacker number. I hope you enjoyed this idea. I will very soon come back with some another interesting idea in mathematics. Till then, goodbye, take care. Thank you.